everyone. Thank you for joining us. I'm Joni Petrie with Cannata's in the Kitchen today with Chef George Caslow, Chef Tony DeSalvo. We have a great simple menu for us for all the party events. And guys, how about you tell us about it?
Okay, here we go today. First of all, as you notice, we have a little bit on the grill, just a medley of peppers. We're gonna start off today with our top sirloin sliders. And Chef is gonna go ahead and get the steak. By the way, this is a certified Angus beef. I took them out of the back of the store.
Okay.
Chef is gonna put them on the grill. They're gonna be fine sliced on an angle, on a bias. And eventually, they're gonna wind up on these egg and butter rolls or these pistolettes. Okay, so that's gonna start us off. Chef, you have anything to say about the top sirloins?
Great cut of meat, fairly inexpensive, you know, but a great cut basically for anything. Again, it's gonna be real tender. You can use salt and pepper. I'm just gonna go ahead and use a little rub. You wanna cook it to your desired temperature. You don't wanna overcook it. You can throw it on there. Again, it might be a little cold this weekend, so if you wanna do it indoors, use a skillet in the oven. You know, save you some time, save you a few doctor bills.
It's also a great appetizer, right? You can
right.
start off with that on the bun before you get to your main dish.
Right, or it could be your main dish. Matter of fact, as an appetizer, we have some steak fingers.
Excellent, these steak fingers right here. I'm telling you, by the way, certified Angus beef.
Certified Angus beef.
Always.
I think he likes saying that.
No. We've got a beautiful pistolette. Let me tell you a little bit about these.
Yeah, because
that's fingers.
Wrapped in bacon.
Wrapped in bacon, stuffed with
Jalapeno ground beef.
Now, these two are certified Angus beef steak fingers. Take a bite. You can't
okay.
resist.
All right, you force it.
Can't resist.
Very
nice,
good.
Nice, huh?
Very good.
That stuffing is the same stuffing that we were just talking about. And we had on another show. Who was it? Who? Your grandma?
That was Morton's
mom. Or your mother-in-law? Okay. Well, if you like the stuffing and you like bacon and you like steak fingers, certified Angus beef.
And it adds just a little bit extra to it.
I think you really love this dish.
Again, we have avocados on sale, one of the biggest times to make guacamole. Everybody's kind of taken back. You know, it's a real simple, you know. Just go ahead and cut those avocados open. Just a little twist in that pit. Pop that out. Real simple. You want to make sure those avocados are ripe, and you'll be able to tell by the color. The darker the color, and you'll be able to tell by the texture and the softness of it. Just go ahead, and again, when they're ripe, they're going to mash really easily.
So you just mix all that
just
up?
Just mix all that together.
Mm. We've got a typical serving.
Your fresh onions.
Tray set up for it.
Garlic.
Mm-hmm.
A little cilantro or chef, go ahead and pronounce
cilantro.
It.
Cilantro.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, I'm not even gonna try that.
Some lime juice, some fresh plum tomatoes, Roma tomatoes, or you know, if you have some out your garden. Whatever you have, you know, it's gonna go well. A little bit of salt, a little seasoning. You know, 7-8 ingredients and it's real simple. And it's fresh. I mean, it's one of new popular condiments, you know, that and salsa, the two most popular.
Oh, yeah, you gotta have some kind of chips and dip to start
exactly.
you off.
It's a classic presentation.
Mm-hmm.
Can't see under the plate, but we got a beautiful black Mexican plate that it's being served on. And while you're holding it, you saw the pit that was taken out?
Yeah.
While you're holding it,
we're going to make you eat
I'll
today.
Eat.
We're going to make you eat today.
It's tailgating. Tailgating, you eat from the time you get there to the time you leave.
This pit gets put, if you have to hold this for any length of time, the guacamole, old wives' tale, this pit that we're kidding around with actually gets put in the guacamole, gets covered with some plastic wrap, minus the chips, of course, goes right in the refrigerator, and it'll keep the green.
Really?
Yes. Okay, so that's old wives' tale to keep the color. Now, while we're over here, I can't resist. Everybody who knows me knows. certified Angus beef. CAB, top 8% of all meat produced in the United States. The T-bones we have are on sale.
That's what we had on the sale.
Exactly.
There we go.
Notice the marbling. Again, this steak has the New York strip attached to the bone. Mm-hmm. And if you look carefully, you could see the shape of the T bone. Now, on the other half, we actually have some porterhouse. And what I mean by porterhouse is we have filet mignon attached to this bone. In a cheap T-bone, you won't see any of this.
You won't have that on there.
No, but again, we are a cut above.
Right.
People know that. They come to our store, they buy a T-bone, they spend less, they're on sale this week, and they also get some filet mignon along with it.
It's a great idea to go and get it now while it's on sale.
Fantastic
and stock up
steak.
And you get the better cut of it.
And it's a great steak if you want to order for two. And remember, we'll cut them for you any thickness. So if both husband and wife, boyfriend and girlfriend, it's a great item to split. Let's go back for a minute to the avocados that Chef was using.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was,
you can
that
see
tasted really good.
Two colors here. Okay.
Green. I don't know, black.
Purple, black. Purple. Now this one is not ripe, and it's going to feel harder to the touch. Mm-hmm. This one is soft enough that it's got some
right.
give in it. You really don't want to make a guacamole with an unripe.
So you need to let it sit.
Avocado. You want to let it sit and get like
so. Until it gets like this.
Exactly. All right, what else? We do have pineapples on sale this week. Great item. We've got some celery on sale, and we've got the Chilean grapes.
Mm.
Okay, so just to let you know again, we are known for our produce.
Those are seedless grapes?
Those are seedless, absolutely. I'd like to show you, because we are still in our tailgating football mode.
Right.
We've got a football right back there, by the way, on the show. But I'd like to just not overlook these flowers. I mean,
no.
This is an arrangement. It's got a face on it, if I can show you the face.
It's one of the little masks.
It's got a face on it. It's got one of these masks. I don't know. Dana was wearing them the other day.
It suits you just fine.
Suits me just fine. If I knew how to put the thing on, I'd be wearing it.
We're going to try it.
Okay. Well, this is just an example of what we do in our floral department.
They do a great job. Those arrangements are
really
very nice. Can be used for any event.
Exactly, any event. Speaking of events, you know, we are your event solutions. What we do for our events, we'll plan the entire event for you. Come on down, work with one of our planning and our catering professionals.
Right.
Right down to the flowers and the decor of the table.
Okay, well, when we come back, we'll talk more about the flowers, the catering. We have another king cake. And we're gonna touch base with Chef Tony. So don't go away, you won't wanna miss what we have next.
Sweet sound. Yes, it's time for Cannata's world-famous king cakes, like apple cinnamon pecan, strawberry cream cheese, king creole praline, blueberry pecan. 60 fabulous flavors. And every Cannata's king cake is made from scratch, the old-fashioned way. That's why we're the official king cake of Mardi Gras. Our king cakes make the perfect gift, and we ship worldwide. Only at Cannata's. A cut above.
If you're interested in all of these recipes, you can visit www.cannatas.com or check out www.htv10.tv. And as we mentioned, flower arrangements are very much a necessity for all these party planning ideas. You can visit www.cannatasflowers.com or just call 985-873-9102. And for every event solution, you can call 985-873-9119.
Mm.
And you need to check out the mask because they have great masks and you could just, you know, play the part and not worry about who you are, right?
Does it matter who you are?
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
I could be whoever I want to be as long as I have this mask on.
Woo-hoo! Excellent. Excellent.
So, you said something about the football earlier.
Let me take your pair from
you. Oh, over here. Okay.
Country style ribs.
Oh, we missed that.
I get carried away with certified Angus beef. Everybody
like
knows why,
it,
right?
But we have ribs.
We've got
too.
Some beautiful country style ribs. Look at the sheen. Look at the color. These are a sale item this week in
okay.
addition to the T-bones.
All right.
And these are gorgeous, Chef. You want to say a few words about them?
Great crock pot meal, especially the day before. Throw them in a crock pot on low. A little bit of season, a little bit of barbecue sauce, and just let them cook. These were actually about 2 hours in the oven on low for about 300. You know, just season them and just hit them with a little sauce at the end.
I never thought about putting them in a crock pot, but that's a good idea,
yeah.
especially when you work.
Tender, tender, fall apart.
Oh.
For the working person,
yes.
before you go to work, put them in a crock pot, leave for work by the time you come home.
You don't have to worry about
ready.
It because it's
no.
it's so stressful when you're at work not knowing what you're going to go home right. and cook for supper. But
exactly.
It's already in the crock pot.
That takes the worry out.
It's a done deal.
Takes the time of preparation out.
There's the football. Isn't that neat?
The football. Okay, now this is one of our Hormel.
Easy little trays.
Easy snack trays.
Pepperoni.
Gorgeous. You come home, pop the top, ready to entertain your friends, some snacks, going along with the sliders. Going along with the steak fingers.
You could take the top off and
I'd like to say going
it.
Along, you could throw it. I could throw it. Anybody out there? All right. Over here we've got a couple of cheeses. And we've actually got five different jack cheese flavors. I've got pesto. What do we have? Hot pepper mm-hmm. here. Also, to go along with the concept and the idea of ease of preparation, and timing being real tight nowadays.
Right.
Open these up, get them on a plate, serve here.
Grab a little
boom,
toothpick.
Done. Little toothpick. You're so civilized.
Yes.
Okay. And
this is
to
the
go
chocolate
from pre-meal to post-meal.
Chocolate devotion, right?
Chocolate devotion.
Chocolate devotion.
And it has chocolate chips in it.
Chocolate chips and French silk filling, which is almost like a chocolate pudding.
Oh.
Yeah, it is like a pudding.
That sounds
the,
good.
This is our, I think it's our fifth.
You know she wants a piece, George. Go ahead and cut that.
You said you was feeding me today. You cannot feed me all this stuff and not the sweets.
Oh, we're going to feed you now. Watch out for this, baby. I'm going to cut you a small slice for our show. You know, normally everybody takes a nice size slice. Now be careful.
All right, here we go. Cameraman's about to get jealous.
I'm gonna get you a little bit of towel because I see it coming.
Mmm, that's good. Really
nice.
Good. Mm-hmm.
There we go.
I like it. And then we have our little kids pack king cake,
and
right?
then we have the children's pack king cake.
And that one's stuffed with the Bavarian cream.
And that's stuffed with Bavarian cream.
So they can decorate it.
Head. They can decorate it. It's got the sugars.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if we can get a
really
look at
fun.
That.
Something fun for the kids to do. And then
got
they
the
can
baby.
Actually, great for the adults that don't like a lot of sugar either.
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
Good idea, Chef. Everybody, good idea.
Everybody's a kid at heart.
All right, looks like the steaks have come off the grill.
And that's for the sliders, right?
That's for the sliders.
Sirloin sliders.
And he's gonna top that with these sauteed peppers.
Mm.
Okay, so when he goes to serve and plate up, he's already, if you notice as a professional, he's laid his rolls out.
Oh, those are cooked perfect
right?
for me.
Beautiful.
And again, if you want it a little bit cooked, you know, I call it the gray meat, but you know, not everybody likes that.
Gray meat.
Yeah.
You can say it. It's okay.
Kind of a heartbreaker sometimes because once you go past that medium, sometimes you lose a lot of the flavor.
And the juice, huh?
Yeah.
It can
exactly.
get dry if
exactly.
you go
It'll
too
dry
long.
Out. Exactly.
We'll top those off. And again, we gotta have some of those
yeah,
ribs that are gonna
ribs.
Fall off.
And you miss a little bit of that color. On the other end, you can see it. Those beautiful vegetables that were sauteed. And here we do have the baked country style ribs on the same plate. I don't think there's much more for me to say.
Nope. There you have it. We have our baked ribs and our sirloin sliders. Don't forget about the desserts. The chocolate devotion was really great. Our kids pack, floral arrangements, and any event that you're planning,
catering.
Call Event catering. Solutions at Cannata's. They can make all the arrangements for you, make it really easy. So y'all have a great time planning y'all events, guys.
And don't
doesn't
forget,
matter who cooked it.
It's where you got it.
That's right.
And just like Danny would say, flowers make every day extraordinary.
Extraordinary. Woo-hoo! See you next time.
Bye. Bye.
Just a one-night stand, and he asked to see me next week, and I told him I could.